suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and he descended into hell, the third day rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty, and thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead.
And the Holy Spirit is the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful
passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful
passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful
passion, have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Father, we offer you the body and blood, soul, and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
In atonement for our sins.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow, for the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the Father, help you the body and blood, soul, and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
In atonement for our sins and the hopes of the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his soul,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his soul,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his soul,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his soul,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the Father, the Holy Body, and blood, soul, and divinity of your dear and beloved Son, and Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrow,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, Jesus is present today for you, for your family. He's sending you, he's sending me, he's sending us to bear fruits, fruits of love, peace, forgiveness. As you know, my brothers, my sisters, that sometimes it's not like this. It is why this morning all together we say, I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my pride, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. Show favor, Lord, to your servants and gracefully increase the gifts of your.
The Lord our God is the shepherd, guards his flock. the virgins shall make merry and dance, and young men and old as well. They will turn their mourning into joy. I will console and gladden them after their sorrows.
The Lord guards us as the shepherd guards his flock.
The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it, and the evil one comes and steals away what was sown in his heart. The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and received at once with joy, but he has no root and lasts only for a time. When some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away. The seed sown among thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches shut the word, and it bears no fruit. But the seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who in it bears fruit and yield at 100, or 60, or 34. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
you, Lord. Good morning, my brothers and sisters.
Morning.
How are you doing this morning?
Praise,
praise the Lord. Because he's taking care of you. All our families, all the nations, he is taking care of this world. As a shepherd, the Lord will gather his people together. This is the project, to be together, to be one. And one of the documents of the Second Vatican, Lumen Gentium, talking about the church, this document is saying that all together, nations, the five continents, we have brothers and sisters, Catholics, together as one family. This big family we call the church. At the head of this church is Jesus, our Redeemer. And he's trying day by day to help us to be one, to love one another, and to build the kingdom, the church, here, the local church in Utah, the church in USA, the church in Africa, the church in Europe, the church in Asia, all the five continents, we need to be together. One people, the new people of God. We are these people, my brothers, my sisters. We need to understand this, that we are one family, Jesus' family, if we will do the will of God, day by day, and then we are brothers, sisters, mom of our Lord Jesus. All the nations to be one. Secondly, the word planted in your heart, in my heart, is to grow and bear a bountiful fruit. Love, forgiveness, peace, justice, day by day. And to bear fruit, the secret is to be closer to Jesus. If we are not closer to Jesus, united with Jesus, we cannot bear fruit, my brothers, my sisters. Day by day, we need to look for this connection with Jesus, a connection with our brothers and sisters. As today we are praying also for our brothers and sisters who was coming here in Utah, here in USA, like a pioneer, to bring something. We have Catholics also here in Utah, bringing peace, bringing love, and we need to be united all together. All the denominations, I know that we can talk about ecumenism. All the churches proclaiming Jesus as a Lord, as a Redeemer, we can talk, we can be together. And also with other religions who have kind of relationship. And Nuestra Aetate, one of the documents of the Second Vatican, gave us this opportunity to dialogue, inter-religious dialogue with our brothers and sisters. I know, and Pope Francis, as a dream, maybe one day, brothers and sisters who are divided, you know, one day we will return. Maybe, who knows, one day to be one nation, one people, one church. Day by day, brothers and sisters, pray for our church here in Utah, and may the seed we are rooting today bear fruit, vocations, priests, deacons, religious to serve our church here in Utah. And may our Mother Mary intercede for us, for our church here in Utah, in USA. And may God bless you. Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us join together in faith as we present our prayers to the Father.
The Mass this morning is offered for Father Sébastien Sasa. For this intention, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may richly bless and be gracious to Pope Francis and all clergy as they continue to lead the faithful in truth and wisdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ may guide the hearts and minds of those in positions of authority as they support policies that protect the dignity and sanctity of human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are ill, particularly those with COVID-19, that God free the world from the virus, heal those who are afflicted, and protect others from developing the disease. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an end to abortion and for the legal protection of unborn children everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our military troops engaged in dangerous missions, that they be protected by God watching over them, and return safely to their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those in this faith community may grow in their knowledge of the Word and strength of their faith through the grace of the sacraments, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our faithful departed, including Jim Backus, for whom Our Lady of Grace candle burns this week. May they now rejoice in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our personal petitions, let us pause in silence. For all of these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Thank you, Lord, for your presence in our family of St. George. Help us by the grace of the Holy Spirit to build your kingdom here in our family of St. George. Kingdom of love, forgiveness, peace, and justice. We ask all this, O Lord, in the beloved name of your Son Jesus, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all our creation, for to your goodness we have received the bread we offer this morning, Father, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all the creation, for to your goodness we have received the wine we offer this morning, Father, fruit of divine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Thank you.
The Lord to be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up your heart.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Indeed, it is right and just our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And his coming in glory we await with unwearying hope. And so, with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without a hand we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of glory. O Son of righteousness, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. O Son
of righteousness. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending thy own Spirit upon the angel form, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and then in waiting in his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given now for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be put up for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim
your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you are worthy to be in your presence this morning and minister to you. Although we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oscar, our Bishop, and all the clergy, our pastor Father Dean, our deacons, Rob, Rigoberto, Sebastien, and your people present this morning, O Lord Jesus. Take care of them. Bless, O Lord Jesus, all my brothers and sisters sick, and especially those with COVID-19. Bring peace, life, send upon our brothers and sisters, physicians, priests, deacons, lay people taking care, spiritual care of them. You know that they need your help. And to our brothers and sisters who have responsibilities in our cities, in our state of Utah, in our country, in the world, may your wisdom help them to take good decisions to help the people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fasted asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph of Cross, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint George, Saint Juan Diego, Saint Jose Sanchez de Leon, we blessed you to our ages. We may be to be glorious to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
One God, one Spirit, and all together we are brothers and sisters. And then we can pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is. Give us this day our daily bread, and give us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grace us with peace in our days, in our families, in our big family of St. George, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we will be blessed over the coming of our Son, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, and now to our family of St. George, peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grace us within her, peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Try to share this peace, not with your hands, but with big smile. Peace. Lamb of God.
Lord, have mercy.
presence in our family of St. George. But you know that some of our brothers and sisters, they cannot receive you sacramentally. But right now, spiritually, they are receiving you. Be with them, and may they continue your mission, being good disciples, missionaries of peace, love, and forgiveness. Amen.
Nobody.
Same here. with your Father, with the Holy Spirit, our one. Especially this morning, we offer you, O Lord, all our families to be united. Especially this morning, we offer you, O Lord, all the nations to be in peace. Especially this morning, we offer you, O Lord, all our brothers and sisters sick. You, Jesus, are the physician of all the physicians in this world. And then you can do more and more and more and more. Thank you, Jesus, for your presence in our big family of St. George. Thank you, Jesus, for giving us this morning the opportunity to continue your mission. Thank you, Jesus.